Hi, and welcome to Workflow from Home, a mini-series dedicated to exploring the tools and techniques that help professionals investigate and implement the workflows from within the cloud. My name is Michael, and you can't see the mess in here, but as evidenced by it, I am still working from home. In this episode, we're focused on some important aspects of cloud asset management as it relates to teams of people, such as editors, VFX artists, colorists, or even sound teams. We're going to explore a specific cloud-based workflow today, but yours will certainly differ. So just use this as a base to customize this workflow to fit your needs. In episode one, we talked about identifying whether or not a pure cloud workflow or hybrid workflow is best for you. We also discussed that some productions require an air gap solution. An air gap is arguably the highest security measure in which the NLE itself must not be connected to the internet. Some air gap solutions are in place because there's a concern over the question, is the cloud secure? That's a logical question, but we believe it's the wrong question. The question we should be asking is, am I using the cloud securely? Consider this. The overwhelming majority of cloud breaches come from people who were authorized to have footage access in the first place. It's true, look it up. Plus, we already use the cloud to shuttle our dailies, our rough cuts, our reviews, and our final VFX files. Now, there are certainly examples in which vulnerable companies have been legitimately hacked, but properly secure use of the cloud will prevent intruders as well as maintain efficiency. I'm sure you have an opinion on this, and we encourage that. This is a tough topic to talk about, and we don't have all the answers, but forward progress starts with a conversation, and now is absolutely the time to start that conversation. Now, all that being said, if your production company does require an air gap, you probably will be better off exploring a hybrid cloud workflow. That's why we talked about the importance of centralizing media into a secure space so that it can be accessed by your remote teams. It also means that after downloading, it can be localized to a system running whatever tools you prefer. So the workflow we're going to build here is one that has four editors and four assistants working from home, working in tandem, and dealing with VFX pulls, preparing for a turnover, and they need to have their actual edit system air gapped. So how do we do that? Well, let's start with uploading. When it comes to remote offline, productions can best prepare for everyone to work from home by uploading key assets to a secure cloud solution. There are numerous ways you can do that. Some are easy, some are complex, but it's fair to say that simplified uploading is one of the cornerstones in which Frame.io is built. Frame.io behaves like a hyper-secure virtual desktop to which all your assets can be easily migrated and managed in the cloud. Post houses, assistants, post supervisors, VFX supervisors can all start by organizing Frame.io in the way you want to work, similar to the way that you would on a local SAN, a direct attached RAID, or even a data asset manager. When it comes to massive amounts of assets, organization is key. So to get that going, we can start where things look familiar, on our own computers. Here I have the infamous project titled The Lost Lederhosen, and I'm making folders that represent different parts of the workflow. We can create a template to organize all the different parts of the post process. We can separate them based on file type, department, or date. Once I've built my folder tree on the local drive, I can drag and drop them into Frame.io, which will rebuild each directory in the cloud and respect your local folder tree arrangements. It will populate these assets if they exist, or create empty folders where they don't. Let's start with the directory marked dailies. I can create new folders and make them private or public to users in the project. Just like on your local network, I can sort these assets in a number of ways. I can delete unwanted folders or unwanted assets. I can modify the name of any folder or modify the name of any asset. And I can move or copy assets to any other directories at any point. Just like you would in a facility, this type of organizational asset management is all in preparation for efficient offlining between a team of editors. For our air gap edit, the workflow here starts by uploading your offline media so that it can be downloaded by each editor to work locally. To comply with the offline air gap ruling, an editor will need a local drive to work with. Now, there's a lot of options out there, but I personally use a GTEC G-Speed Shuttle. This is a great tool because it's extremely powerful. It's scalable with several different storage capacities. It's whisper quiet. In fact, it's in the room running behind me. And it requires no IT support for setup. Think of the G-Speed Shuttle as a private SAN or Nexus. It can support multiple RAID configurations. And because it comes with a Thunderbolt 3 connection, it gives you the speed of a large SAN with one directly attached cable. even if you're working from a laptop, the G-Speed Shuttle can do 1,000 megabytes per second. In our air gap workflow, each editor can download media to our local RAID using an online computer and then disconnect it and move it to an offline computer for the edit process. This requires each editor to have their own G-Speed, but each editor can store over 3,000 hours of DNX36 locally. Now, we discussed codec sizes and calculating download times in episode 1. Most people's home internet is easily capable of keeping up with the edit dailies each day, so offline media in this workflow shouldn't be a problem. But in our workflow, the AEs also need to manage VFX shots. And while our air gap workflow is adequate for offline, it isn't possible to download all the original camera files locally since they can be up to 100 times bigger than the offline media. So when it comes to a VFX pull workflow, we need to centralize the original camera files, or OCF, into the cloud as well. As you know, raw files can be big, so getting OCF files up may take a while. But after the offline media is uploaded, it's really important to start uploading that OCF because it will really help streamline your VFX pulls, your marketing pulls, as well as the entire DI turnover process when working with those large teams. Since many post houses are able to keep their vaults open, our workflow is using one of those companies to continue our cloud centralization process by uploading all of the OCF into the Frame.io cloud. With these large asset transfers, our post vendor will want a way to move lots of files to multiple directories. To do this, Frame.io has a dedicated uploader application that you can download for free on the Mac App Store called Frame.io Watch Folders. After you install the Frame.io uploader, select the app from the menu bar, log into your account, and select a local directory that you want to upload. Since I was already working off an Avid Nexus, I can take the same directory structure and tell Frame.io to mirror that structure by selecting Upload Subfolders and Preserve Folder Structure. This is a good trick for keeping your file structures familiar. Next, I select a destination directory in Frame, and the uploader will begin migrating all the assets while respecting your pre-existing directory structures. Everything in Frame will appear exactly the same way as it did on your SAN. So now we have a couple of different ways to keep working with our cloud media. As we've said before, in a pure cloud workflow, like Avid's Edit On Demand, this is a great time to start remote editing from home on a system that's online all the time. Or you could use a remote control tool like Teradici or HP's remote graphics software to tunnel into your remote NLE. But if you want the control and the air gap security of local performance, we need to begin downloading assets onto our removable local drive. To do that, Frame.io has a new tool called Frame.io Transfer. This will be available later this year. After I log into Transfer through my Frame.io account, I can select a root directory with all my edit media and initiate a download to the folder of my choice. Again, Transfer respects all folders within Frame.io and formats them on your local drive using the same paths. The Transfers button shows you the progress, and it will save a log to your computer so that you can check the results as media is localized. For the fastest results, it may be best to copy media directly from your SAN to your drive prior to working from home. But in the event that that opportunity has already passed, this workflow is giving all our editors identical material downloaded through the Frame.io Transfer app, and the next day they can work offline using their direct attached storage. Now that our editors are cutting, we need to keep the VFX artists working by providing them access to the raw files for compositing. Because we preemptively centralize all the OCF in Frame.io, we can access the raw files that we need in order to prepare raw files for VFX turnovers. We'll need to use an online computer to do this. So one option is to create a VFX shots list based on each pull list. I've set that up with today's date. Next, I can manually navigate to the VFX shots needed, select them, and choose Copy To, and move them to my VFX shots folder. After I finish populating this directory, I have the option to share these files to the VFX artist using the new folder sharing feature available in Frame.io this April. A more automated option is to export an EDL or XML from your edit timeline that includes the VFX shots for this pull. These, of course, are generated by the offline dailies. Then we go back to a computer terminal that's connected to the cloud and open the Frame.io transfer tool. This time we choose Set List. This allows us to upload our pull list to Frame.io Transfer and navigate to the OCF folder, which contains all of the original camera files. Once we hit download, Frame.io Transfer will use the pull list EDL to dig through all the OCF folders and automatically find matches and then initiate downloads of all the clips that were only matched within the pull list. We can also initiate multiple transfers at once to different directories, while the transfers button shows us our progress. At this juncture, you have a couple of options. First, Frame.io transfer is similar to LTO in that it will not trim clips, so a pull list will download the entire take associated with the edit. That means you can either A, deliver the list to VFX artists to use Frame.io transfer to pull down selects for compositing themselves, or B, you can pull the whole take down and then reconform them with your list in a tool like Resolve, which will trim them. Option B is the best choice when working with limited bandwidth. In this case, we would reconform the takes in Resolve by using the same initial pull list, then setting them to output as trimmed EXR or log files, which is a more typical way of VFX management. And I can set a target directory for the VFX pull list in the Frame.io cloud, and Resolve will automatically render and upload newly trimmed files. We can include the corresponding reference file, the LUT and CDL color files, and then add our VFX vendor to this directory and share the assets as a review link where the appropriate parties can be notified of the file arrival. The best part of all, this can all be done while working from home. So let's re-examine this workflow. First, we localize all the dailies into Frame based on an ideal air gap workflow. For large uploads, we use the Frame.io watch folder tool to upload assets to specific directories and mirrored the same structure that's on our original SAN. The editors and AEs downloaded the offline material from Frame to a local disk and then edited on an air-gapped computer. We also had the post house upload all the OCF to Frame.io. When it came to a pull list, the AEs exported an EDL or XML and uploaded that to the Frame transfer tool, which pulled down just the selected takes in the list. We trimmed those in Resolve and then published the trim clips back to Frame and shared them with the VFX vendors. The key takeaways here are, Frame.io behaves like a hyper-secure virtual desktop in which all your assets can be easily migrated and easily managed in the cloud. Frame.io respects folder trees on both the upload and download processes. Users don't have to zip or isolate assets before sending or receiving them. And users can set up, modify, copy, or even move assets after they're already in the cloud. Thank you to everyone who has provided suggestions and topics to cover in this series. If you found this information helpful, please let us know. We're trying to explore a number of solutions for professionals who are interested in a workflow from home, and we'd love to hear from you. Let us know what you want us to cover more of, and please don't hesitate to ask questions. These workflows are probably not exactly your workflow, but together, if we sort this out, we can find a way to solve as many problems as possible so that we can all workflow from home.